If you want to create this retro spinning animation right in After Effects, then this is the video for you. Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel. My name is King Sam and I make motion graphic and graphic design content right here on YouTube. You can also join my motion design community. The link is in the video description. And this another episode in our ongoing series called Minuitetorials. And this is where I bring you After Effects tips and tricks in less than 2 minutes. So let's get 2 minutes on the board and let's jump right into the video.
Okay, so we're in After Effects here. Let's create a new composition, 1920 by 1080, 30 frames per second, and for 6 seconds. And now, first of all, I'm just going to create a new solid and just make it any color. And first I'm going to apply here is I'm going to apply a gradient ramp. Gradient ramp on my solid here. I'm going to change this color to orange, and I'm also going to change this color to something lighter, so it's kind of yellow. Yeah, cool. Now I can change this to radial ramp, and I'm just going to move this to the middle right here. Now I can swap the colors, then I'll move this out so that the radial ramp looks a little bit better. Now I can lock this layer because I don't need it anymore. And I'm going to my pen tool here, and I'm first going to the middle of my composition here, and I'm going to make a point at composition. Hold down shift, let's zoom out a bit. Hold down shift, and I'm just going to click it here so I can make a straight line. Now I can increase my width to any length I want. So I think like this is okay. Now I'm going to open up my layer here. I'm going to open up my contents, open up shape, open up stroke, and open up taper. And my start length here, I'm just going to increase it to 100. Now next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to add a repeater here. And I'm going to open up my repeater properties, and for my copies here, I'm just going to write 10. And I'm going to open up my transform repeater property here, and for my position, I'm going to click 0. Now, for my rotation here, I'm just going to increase it until I can see that the space between them is almost identical. So something like this is okay. And the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to open my scale property. I'm going to scale it up like this so it covers everywhere. Now, I can open my rotation property again. Now I'm going to alt-click the stopwatch, and I'm going to write a simple expression. Time asterisk 20. So, what that does is that you're just going to allow it to move, have this simple motion. And final thing I'm going to do is that I want to blend it in. So in case you are not seeing this, you can hit your toggle between modes here, and I want to change the blending mode to soft light so that you have something like this.
Thank you for watching that video. What do you think? Let me know in my comment section. Please like, share, and subscribe if the video has helped you in any way. Say to somebody that you think this video is going to help, and I'll catch you in the next video. So from now to then, remember, improve every day, grow constantly, and dream endlessly. Love you guys.